delighted to host you this evening. The E.E. Hall Memorial Scholar Awards honors the memory of Mr. Elbert E. Hall, one of Abilene's most treasured public figures of the 20th century. Hall's civic leadership in Abilene spanned four decades and included terms as mayor, school board member, and a charter member of the Community Foundation. His service to the state of Texas included board memberships for the Texas Department of Mental Health and Mental Retardation and the State Bar Board of Texas as its first lay member. In 1991, Hall agreed to become a member of McMurray's Ignite Advisory Board just 8 months before he passed away. After Hall's death, the Ignite Advisory Board established the E.E. Hall Memorial Scholar Award to honor Mr. Hall's life and leadership. Each spring, department heads from across the divisions of arts and letters, well, they're different divisions now, natural and computational sciences and humanities and social sciences, which were formerly colleges of arts and sciences, solicit nominations for distinguished faculty scholars who have served McMurray University for at least 5 years and who are widely recognized for exemplary research. Each E.E. Hall Memorial Scholar receives a generous cash stipend for use in furthering his or her scholarly work. Today, Dr. David Amlong, Associate Professor and Chair of the Music Department, is our 2021 E.E. Hall Memorial Scholar. Hailing from the suburbs of Cincinnati, Ohio, David's musical journey has taken him across much of the United States. He's held faculty positions at Indiana State University, Middle Tennessee State University, and of course, McMurray University. David's professional activities and scholarly achievements are abundant, diverse, and stellar. He's appeared with the Oklahoma City Philharmonic, the Columbus, Indiana Philharmonic, Symphony Orchestras of Terre Haute, Richmond, Indiana, Danville, Columbus, Hamilton Fairchild, and others. David has played under the baton of esteemed conductors David Robertson, Giancarlo Guerrero, Mario Vanzago, Joe Levine, Otto Warner Mueller, David Hayes, Joseph Culinary, Paul Nadler, and David Efron. An active chamber musician and recitalist, David has appeared in solo and chamber situations in a variety of noteworthy venues, including Carnegie Hall's Weill Recital Hall, Alice Tully Hall in New York City, Symphony Space in New York City, Civic Center Music Hall in Oklahoma City, and also the Capitol Center University Conservatory of Music, as well as a number of university appearances, such as Texas Christian University, University of Denver, Bard College, Murray State University, Wichita State University, Indiana State University, Indiana University, Mann's College of New York, New School for Music, and the University of Oklahoma. And I really did pull just a tiny bit out of his CV to share with you tonight. So in my view, David is a true scholar, and he's an awesome role model for our music majors. Please join me in warmly welcoming David this evening.
Thank you. first piece was one of the very first pieces that I had the pleasure of working at with a consortium. What that basically means is that was an existing work for trumpet piano, the version you just heard. And then in 2017, my second year here on the faculty, there was a call for a consortium to make a wind band accompaniment arrangement. So I got to play that with the McMurray Wind Ensemble that spring, and it was a great pleasure. Obviously, trying to put a whole wind ensemble together for just tonight, a little harder. So I played you the version that was original with trumpet and piano. So I really appreciate the faculty being here and their support in nominating and being selected for this award. It's really a passion of mine, as the program said, that I want you all to be able to hear new music for a trumpet, not just the things that are already out there and recorded. And so it just so happens that one of our fellow trumpet players slash composers here in town, who has since joined the faculty here at McMurray, is one of my best friends in town, Dr. Bernie Scher. He's sitting over there. You're going to hear a little bit from him a little bit later when we play his second piece. But in 2020, my father passed away after a short battle with cancer, and I wanted to have something written in memory of him. And I asked Bernie, and he jumped on it. I think he actually sent me the piece within a week. He works very quickly and does tremendous work. And it's a really lovely piece of music. That's why, as you see, I've titled the recital Evening Reflections. The studio recording CD that I want to record this summer is titled Evening Reflections as well. And it's been a treat to get to work with Bernie. Bernie describes this piece as kind of the evolution of your relationship between father and son. So it starts out with this nice evening melody with a chance to kind of reflect on my time that I had with my father before he passed away. The middle section of the piece kind of goes through the love-hate relationship you might have with a parent, and then also the humor you might share throughout your life and times. After that, there's a return to the opening material where Bernie designed it as a way for me to start building and reflecting on memories of life with my own son, who at the time was not even 1 year old. And if you look at the program, that is actually him sleeping on my lap when he was a baby. And so that is the whole Evening Reflections title, the picture on the front of the program. And he's been really good so far. He is over here. So, and I'm sure he will make his presence known at intermission and after the recital. So, we would like to share with you Evening Reflections by Dr. Bernie Scher.
Thank you.
So we are going to have a short intermission because I wanted my students who are going to play on the next piece with me as the accompanist, the trumpet ensemble, to be able to listen to the first half before they go warm up instead of just running on stage and not being ready to play. So we'll have about 10-minute intermission real quick while my students run and we get the stage set up, and we'll be right back. Thank you.
Thank you.
enhancements to it or anything. So the only thing we really have to do is the kind of things that you're hearing tonight, either new music or different arrangements of music that had existed. What we're gonna about to play is a Scandinavian folk song that I heard years ago for the first time as a trumpet plus organ piece and just loved it. It's one of my favorite pieces of music to listen to. And then I did an arrangement in 2017 for trumpet ensemble that you're gonna hear now. And I did it at Northeastern State University in Tahlequah at a guest residency recital that I did up there. It's about an hour directly south of Tulsa, Oklahoma. After that, this arrangement sat dormant for quite a while because I lost all my files that were on one computer, and all I had were the hard copy files, and I never really had a chance to pull it back out and put it back in the computer. So I did it for this recital and wanted to get the chance to perform with my students. Other things that we can do for research, we've done either commissioning through like Bernie, or we did a new music project several times where we've had over 200 pieces sent to us from all around the world that we selected winners and then did public performances of. I have personally commissioned 15 different pieces that have been all performed pretty much by myself for either trumpet and piano, trumpet and band. One was trumpet, flute, and piano. One was trumpet and percussion. So all different styles of ensemble plus trumpet ensemble. And then with my work here at McMurray, one of the great things that we get to do is actually arrange music that our student ensembles can play as well. So I've done almost 30 arrangements that our jazz band has played or I have actually played on stage here in different recital situations. And this is going to be one of them. So I hope you enjoy. I cannot pronounce it. I believe it's called Gamle Fabeltsong von Delarna. But if you know Scandinavian language, I don't know, Norwegian or Swedish or something, you can correct me after the there's actually a luxury you have. Tonight, the composer of several of our works is here, one of my great friends and one of my fellow faculty members here at McMurray. Figured I would let him come up and say a few words about this next piece, The Long Goodbye. Bernie Scherer.
Before I begin, I want to thank David. One of the things about being a composer is that you get to write for your friends. And man, let me tell you, it is so great to have talented friends like these two guys up here. Okay, so The Long Goodbye. So when David asked me to write this piece, I already had been thinking about a piece to write, something serious actually. So people who have Alzheimer's disease or they battle cancer for a long period of time, it seems like they're taken away from us over just months, maybe even years. And so it's a long goodbye. The people who are with those people and accompanying them through those final months and years, perhaps, you know, there's a sense of gradual loss, and then, of course, the inevitable happens. And so there's that grieving period. So this piece, I wrote that to express the emotions of going through that experience. And so what you're going to hear is right at the beginning, the shock of the diagnosis. And then there's going to be long periods of going up and down, dealing with various episodes and passages of time, moments of hope when things look up, and then when things look down, dealing with those sad thoughts, and finally of the person passing, and then the grief that's associated with that. Ultimately, though, I brought my faith into that last bit because I do not believe death is the end of a human, especially their eternal and immortal soul. And so therefore, at the very end of the piece as a coda, I have that person, of course, who had lived a life in pursuit of the Lord. And so they enter the blessed realm. So that is the general outline of the composition. I did want to mention one fact about the earlier piece that I wrote for David. David shares his first and last initials with his father, D and A. And so he asked me to incorporate that into the composition you heard first. And so that's what I did. It was the second thing. Da 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 ba da da dee dee da 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 da. Those pitches, da da. Did I get that right? D and A. Oh, see, sorry. Alright, so anyway, those pitches are David and his father's initials. So thank you. Go on, goodbye.
Like Bernie said, getting to work with your friends, asking them to write music for you, and then getting to play it is just a great joy, and we can't have a better person to work with here at Abilene than Bernie Scherer. The earlier piece, The Evening Reflections, that he just sang some of, that I actually have forgot about the DA relationship, that one was also featured at an International Trumpet Guild conference that they did a virtual COVID conference, so we did a video recording in this room that was played, and then this work was originally scored for full band and trumpet soloist, and I premiered that, and then I liked it so much that I wanted to be able to use it elsewhere, and asked him to make a piano reduction of his wind ensemble scoring. That's what we're going to play today,
again, a little hard to put a whole band on stage and really get all the rehearsal time in. This work has since been heard at various universities. I believe other university students have played it, and even last summer at the William Adam Trumpet Festival, International Trumpet Festival in West Virginia at Marshall University, I played this as a featured guest artist. So I hope you enjoy The Long Goodbye.
Thank you.
trumpet and piano. It's originally for a trio, I believe, electric piano, bass, and drums. And I thought it was really cool to add the trumpet part. So I made this arrangement that has all four of us playing. Mark and I did it with a few other players, and I believe around 2017 on one of my recitals here.